Well, the toy wars are heating up as retailers launch their campaigns for the all-important holiday shopping season. Bloomberg's Vera Gibbons joins us now with more on that story. And Vera, tell us about the latest toy campaigns.
Well, they're certainly more aggressive than ever. Everyone's trying to steal market share. So you've got Kmart. They unveiled its first list of 15 hot toys. Walmart's going to offer about 100 toys for $10 or less. They had a similar program last year, so looking to capitalize on the success of that. And then we've got Sears, which has been out of the toy business for years. They're now back in it on an experimental basis, having installed all these new toy departments, 20 stores in 5 major markets. So everyone's, again, trying to capture market share.
Well, Vera, it seems like the holiday campaigns are getting earlier and even earlier.
I know. That's the thing. It's not even Halloween yet, so they are getting earlier and earlier. You know, 2 weeks ago, we got an even bigger announcement by Toys R Us. It's going to open all these temporary stores and malls across the USA. That's where all that hiring is coming into play. You mentioned 35,000 jobs. But basically, it's what it's trying to do is take advantage of all the growing number of vacant storefronts, a lot of them out there. They're trying to reach as many customers as possible. This is a first for Toys R Us. And, of course, it comes at a time when retailers are fighting for a piece of the shrinking holiday gift budgets and families' newfound routine of frugality.
And Toys R Us, is the chain ever going to regain its title as the nation's largest toy retailer?
You know, it doesn't look that way. I spoke to Howard Davidovits this morning. He says it's actually not looking to regain its title as number one. They lost that title to Walmart a decade ago, never regained it. It is looking, however, to secure the number two spot. Now, Toys R Us used to have 30% of the market. Right now, it's got about half of that, neck and neck with Target for the number two slot. So this latest expansion tactic, Mark, as well as their strategy of offering exclusive products you can't find anywhere else, could secure them in that number two spot, at least for the holiday season, Mark.
Bloomberg's Vera Gibbons. And Best Buy also plans to hire more workers for the holidays. The world's largest electronics retailer says it needs to meet demand for internet-connected flat-panel TVs and mobile phones. Best Buy CEO Brian Dunn told reporters here in New York today the company sold more flat-panel TVs in July than last December and expects to sell more during the holidays this year. He didn't specify the number of seasonal employees the chain plans to hire.